For this antenna experiment measurement, I did not use a regular transceiver. It has mainly to do with AGC. The automatic gain control is normally not possible to switch it off with a transceiver, and with this RTL stick it can be done. So you have to untag it. Then the automatic gain control is switched off, and I switched the beacon, the small beacon, I switched it on, so I receive it now, and you have to figure your gain in a way that when you rotate your antenna that you want to measure, that it can fill the whole span here, so that you don't turn the antenna into the other direction and are below, will end up below the noise level. So that's it with the reception. So I now have a clear reception of the beacon I have, and you wait till it is stable, and then we open another program. While rotating your antenna, it is of course possible to keep an eye on this data, and for every 5 or 10 degrees you rotate your antenna, you write it down, and then you plot later the graph. I did it another way. I searched for Spectran, and this is a version with a log possibility. You have also a version without a log possibility. What happens here is that it measures a lot of data and put it all in a text file, and you can use that text file. In fact, this is an audio spectrum, and I can show you that if you receive the tone, you see a clear tone here. And when this becomes weaker or stronger, you see also the tone here going up or down, and you can measure it here or in the tone itself, but you can also measure it later on. But the start lock function and the stop lock function, you can do something with the data to make a clear radiation pattern of your antenna. So let's do it. So I placed the beacon some 60 meters away. Then with this antenna rotator controller I described here, I rotate the antenna that I described here. And this one can go very fast. So I start with zero, and then as I go, while pushing the button, record in the program, and then it turns rather fast. And when I'm at 360 degrees, I switch this off and I push the stop record function. The result of the recordings of the Spectran are just files. I did it three times, one slow and two times with a speed turn. And when you open such file, the name is the date and the time, and when you open it you see that it is the date, the time, the frequency that is measured, and the value in dBs. As you can see, you see no drift in the frequency, you see no distortion, but you can see that the dB value change. What I do now is select all these data, paste it, copy and paste it into an Excel sheet. You get this kind of ID. In my version it cannot calculate with a dot, it needs to have a comma, so I just do search and replace a dot for a comma, and then I have commas, of course. As you can see, the dots are replaced by a comma, and I also added another column. I searched here for the value closest to zero, that's minus 16.5, and I add here in the cell 16.5, so we come to minus 14.3. And I did it with all these. You can select it and pull down, and when we have this column completely filled with correct data, with the highest value of course zero, then we can select the column and we can choose a graph, and we choose for radar. And when we do radar, we can see that we have this kind of radar. You likely do not recognize anything because we did a lot of measurements, but as you can see in the purple line here, this is in fact the graph that is plotted now in dBs, but we have to clean up it a bit to make it look nicer. But as you can see, it is already 360 degrees because that was the complete run that we did with this measurement. So I cleaned the graph a bit, and this is the result. I added some columns here, the 30 degrees values, so that's now the green points here, so I go to 0 and minus 30, so that's why you get here a green circle, that's minus 30, and I made this red, and the blue one here is the minus 3 dB point. So as we can see now, it crosses here and here in 30 degrees. Opening is here the minus 3 dB points. However, yeah, this is also not too deep. This is likely also a reflection or so. And this is also not too deep. These black lines are the minus 10 dB. You can do that in the scale setting. And a minus 10 is not too good. Here minus 13 or so is not too good, but yeah, the antenna is under the roof. What you also see here is a very strange dip here, and I found out that if I look at it here, all the frequencies are 1347 hertz, and this one is a bit different, so likely it shifted a bit, so therefore you see here a dip. So it is here 0 and then here minus 2.3, so that's one measurement only, so I can consider that as a wrong measurement, and I can correct it. You can also rotate the whole figure by just moving a lot of lines to another, to the end, for example. Then you can shift it. If you want to have this point here, then you must shift it like 30, 45 degrees or so. So you find out which value it is here, 45 degrees here. So then you need to move these lines to the end, and then it counterclockwise turns. So that's this. It is the antenna under the roof, so a lot of reflections, and I can do the same measurement with the stick, with the beacon, at another place, somewhere at the west side or so, and see if it is comparable with this measurement. Okay. Hopefully you enjoyed this video, and if so, thumbs up, and if you want to see more, then you can subscribe, of course. See you!